Hi, my name is Brandon Dougherty, and I am a field application engineer with FARO Technologies. Today, I want to show you how to use our Scene software to help make some deliverables you may not know about, as well as cleaning up projects to help with file size and exporting. So today is all about deliverables, so let's just jump into the Explore page and start with cleaning up our project. Here, we can see we've got a lot of people in this area, and we just have a lot of excess information if we just want to focus on this plant right here. So what I like to use is the selection tool. First, I like to go into an orthographic view and then jump into a top view immediately. This is going to allow us to look at our area a little bit easier with the lines being able to be seen very easily so I don't delete anything I don't want to. Right here, I'm just going to click on the selection tool, and you may have it looking like this. Just hit this little expand button, and you'll be able to see all these tools. Now, your new selection up here is going to allow you to create a new selection, and we're going to use the polygon tool for this. This is going to allow us to click once, and click again, and again, and again, creating these crazy shapes that if you have an intricate data set, you can really get crazy with cleaning up your points to the best of your abilities. Now, while I am in this tool, if I want to go around, I need to hold the control key and look around. Then I can move my area. And you can see that gets rid of your selection. So you want to just get into your position the first time before doing that. Also, if I zoom in or zoom out, it's going to be inverted, and it's going to not scale to that situation that you're in. So be careful, get into where you want to see the entire thing, whether you want to delete or keep, and then once you make your selection, you're going to double click to end it. You don't want to cross the path here, just end right here, and that's going to select the area. Now, if I may have not gotten everything that I've wanted, I can click the Add Selection tool. Once again, selecting the polygon, I can select an area that maybe I wanted to get as well here. You can see there, it makes that selection. Well, now that I've thought about it, I don't want it. So I switch to the Subtract tool, and I just delete that selection. The Intersect Selection tool is a tool that if I wanted to, just focus on just one part and delete one part of it, I could choose that, and once again, just go around and maybe choose the top half so that I'm not selecting that area. But in this sense, I want to keep everything here, so I'm not going to use that tool. Now that I have my selection, I have a few options that I can do. When I right-click, I can export this selection if I wanted to. And this will just be as the points. I'm not going to have any of the bubble views or the quick views that you may be used to for viewing of pictures. So this will just be the points. If I go to my current selection, once again, export points right here, it's also there. Now, what I don't want to do is I don't want to delete this area because this is what I actually want to keep. So I'm going to go down to invert. This invert will select all the points outside of that current selection, and then with that, I can right-click, go back into the current selection, and delete these points. There we go. Look at that. Now that those are deleted, I have a more focused view on what I want to look at. But I'm not done yet, because when you delete points, it only really knows that you've deleted them once you save. And saving a deletion on larger projects can take a long time. So you want to take out as many points as you can in one fell swoop. So before I save, I am going to take out some people here because I want to make sure that they're not in the way. I want to keep my entryway where it is. So I can go back into perspective view just for better navigation and use this clipping box right here. Now with this clipping box, I could, if I wanted to, just get with this area, but you can see there's some people maybe underneath some areas. So if you're in a building, what I personally like to do is I like to make my entire thing selected And then I like to bring this down until that piping is gone. So you can see there's nothing from the overhead that I'm seeing here. Then I like to bring this part down or up until that flooring selection is gone. So depending on if you have variable increments of height, you may need to do this in multiple ways, but I've gotten my clipping box right where I want it. Now I'm gonna just hit this I right here to get rid of my clipping box. And now I can use a combination of my clipping box tool and my selection tool. So this is very, very useful for cleaning up indoors, especially. I can also use a tool down here called normal coloring to really show me where this noisy data is coming from. So I can see right here, I have something that I want to keep, but then I have all these people over here from multiple scans. Then I'm going to just do a add selection, polygon, and go around and select them. So you can see I'm making a selection with all of that very easily. And I can go along, maybe I see some data right here I can delete. I add that to my selection. So you can just go along and add to your selection, and once you're ready to delete, that's when you can right-click, current selection, and delete points. And there they go. Now I've deleted on a macro level and a micro level. So I've made sure that all of my points are cleaned up. Once again, all it took was two deletions. Maybe it'll take you a little more, but just make sure you don't save after making small changes. So now that we've deleted our points and cleaned it up, I can get rid of my clipping box and I can turn it back to original colors and save. Of course, you want to save as much as you can in Scene. And like I said, this is going to take a little while, so I am going to pause the video and come back when this is ready. And it has now concluded the deletion and saving of those points. It took around 5 to 7 minutes. So now we are back and we are going to go over, of course, some of the deliverables that we talked about. So we can see once again, everything's been deleted, but we may want this to look a little nicer. And remember, we've scanned in this one around 18 or 20 scans of this area. And that means there's a lot of points that might overlap with other scans. So that's just building up my file even more for when I export things. So I can go in and unify these scans under a project point cloud. So right here, project point cloud, this is something you want to do after you are completely done manipulating your area. Because if you do make a project point cloud and then try to delete something, that project point cloud isn't going to be updated automatically. So right here, I'm going to create a project point cloud. It's going to ask me, do you want to eliminate duplicate points? Yes, we do. That's going to, once again, lessen our file size when we export a project point cloud. And then closed surfaces in full color detail. That is not something that a lot of our AEC customers are going to do, because that is going to, at the very least, 10 times your data. So if you've got a 90 gigabyte project, well, you better have a terabyte to spare if you are going to do this. So please, in most cases, do not do this. This is more for parts of things, very small objects. Next is homogenized point density. This is going to uniformly distribute your points just to make it a little bit nicer once again. This can go along with eliminating duplicate points. So usually I have those on in tandem. Last thing we have here is apply color balancing. And you can see just looking at the data that our tanks and some of our pipes look a little bit different in certain areas. And that's just because when you move the scanner, the coloring is going to be determined by the lighting conditions. So applying that color balancing is going to make everything look much, much better. Distance filter, you should not need to apply that because, of course, you should have already cleaned up your data. And make sure your temporary data folder has enough storage or else this will not complete. So once again, I'm going to say OK to this. This is going to start creating the project point cloud, and we will be back in a few minutes. All right, and Our project point cloud took about 10 minutes to make. And now when we go into the view of the project, we can see that it looks much different now. So if you wanted to show people around a point cloud and they're not used to a point cloud, this is going to be the way you want to do it, just because it does some gap filling. Once again, it's a lighter file, so everything just goes around a little bit easier. You can navigate a little bit faster with WASD, and it just makes your life a lot easier on that fact. So before we get into those deliverables that I talked about, let's talk about our export options here. We can export ordered scans, and if I were to click on that, that's going to give us the ability to export multiple E57, RCS, PTS, FLS, if you wanted to do that, all these different types of file types. And these are going to be multiple 18 scan files, or however many you have. So it's just going to put it in a folder wherever you want it. And those that exported ordered scans is going to have the bubble views or the quick views that you're used to in Scene, as well as the scan positions. So it's going to be 18 individual scans. Now, we made a project point cloud. If we export that project point cloud, it is that unified file. So there are no bubble views. There are no scan positions. There's less data in there because we eliminated duplicate points. So this is going to be something that if you're a modeler and you do not want the views, or you do not need the picture views, this is going to be perfect for you because it's going to be a lighter file type. And lastly, export project. That is just going to be for either LSProj, which is what we are working with inside of Scene, or your RCP, which is your recap projects that work in AutoCAD, Revit, anything Autodesk related. That's going to create, once again, multiple ordered RCSs. So you're going to have those bubble views and those locations of the scans. Now, I will say once again, we do have ways of even further reducing the amount of points. We can use our clipping box right here if we wanted to and just say, I want to export this 3D selection. So I can choose just a file type. And once again, you are not going to have any of those bubble views or the quick views that we talked about. But if you just want to care about one section for modeling purposes, you can do that very easily in there. So those are our export selections of just the points right there. Now, let's talk about some of the other things like the overview map. This is a very overlooked feature inside of Scene, and it's very easy to make because after you delete your points and you get it looking how you want, you can create this overview map by just clicking on it, saying create, and it does its job. This is going to give you a 2D floor plan-esque view from a top view, and it's going to also let you navigate in the point cloud a little bit easier. So this is not a AutoCAD level of a floor plan or anything. This is just going to be for those people that want to show maybe their bosses or their customers something very quickly. And you can see here, it creates it fairly quickly. So, you know, if we need to speed this up, we will do that and it will be done in about a minute. All right, and we are back. It's been about a minute or two since we stopped the recording, and it is just about to finish up here. So you can see this is a very quick deliverable that you can have with very minimal work. I just click on that and look at this. You can see everything here. You can see the scan locations, what it actually got in this area, and it's only from a top view. So if I wanted to, I could click in on this area right here on this scan, and I can go to the 3D view, the quick view, or the planar view just by clicking on these. So a really useful tool when you're navigating or presenting to a group of people. And with this, if you go to export, you can actually export this overview map as a TIFF or a DXF file. Now this is not scaled yet to the drawing that you'd be doing, so you would have to still bring in some information there. Okay. And we're just going to go back to here. So that overview map is a very good tool. Last thing we're going to talk about here is the fly-through. So this fly-through is going to allow you to make a video with this project point cloud, since it's all pretty, we're gonna make a video that looks really, really nice, and it's just as if we're walking through this plant. So here, I'm gonna get in my initial position, switch to the walk mode. This allows me to look down and press W, and I will maintain my height. So this is very nice for making the walkthrough nice and smooth. Now, once I get to my initial spot that I want to start the fly-through at, I can click on viewpoints and click create. This is going to allow me to name my first viewpoint. I will just call this pipe one. So my first one, and right here it is over here. Now I'm gonna just W through. Maybe I'll look at this pipe over here, give me an idea of what I'm looking at, and I'm gonna click my viewpoint, create, and it automatically gives me pipe two. Now I'm gonna, once again, look around this way, create another viewpoint, pipe three, and you kind of get the idea here. It's going to be very easy to create multiple views. You're just gonna wanna make sure if you are going around a corner or something, you kind of take a wide turn or else you may go through the point cloud. So I'm just gonna, once again, make my last one here, pipe five. So there's all my viewpoints. Very simple to make. Next, you're gonna save. Of course, we like to save inside of Scene to make sure we don't miss out on anything. And then there's this button up here that most people don't know about, this apps button. Clicking on this will bring up a new menu up here. And if you do not have the Video Pro app, just go into your apps over here, scroll down until you see it, and hit active. You should most likely have that there. Now that you've got that on your screen, you're gonna say create new camera path. And I'm able to just shift click and select all of my scans right here. And I'm just gonna say add these over as my camera path viewpoints. Down here, I have the ability to interpolate my points. So it's going to move around but not go exactly where my points are that I've picked out. And I can preview the path just to make sure I'm not sliding into anything. So you can see right here, this is what it is going to look like. It's gonna be a lot less choppy when we actually look at the data, but here we go. We're gonna look around and we'll look behind ourselves right there. So that is our video. Now, it can get as complicated as it can. I've had 80 viewpoints before and I made a really long video, but usually you wanna stay within that minute or two so that people get captured by your video. So I'm just gonna say go to the next page. It wants us to save the camera path. I will call this pipe and save. And now I can change the video settings. So here I can change where the images are saved. You're gonna want it as an MP4 most likely, and change where the video folder is saved. I'll call it pipe. And here's where you really wanna make sure, like if you have the time to make this video look as good as possible, change this frame rate from 30 to 60. Now this is gonna double the amount of frames, and it is also going to take a little bit longer to create. So you gotta be careful with that. Right here, we can set this to 20 seconds instead of 18, and you'll notice once I click in on this, the frames change as well. So now that I've made these changes, I can see this frame counter going up much more. I might be going a little bit slower than before, but once again, you get the idea behind this. We're trying to make this as good as it can be, so you're making everything go up if you want it to look good. So the last part of this is just to hit that start button. And for this does take a while. So I am going to, once again, end this part here, and I will leave you with the video that comes after this. But as we saw today, you have a lot of things that you can do in Scene other than just exporting the data right after you register it. So please use these tools as you can and enjoy the video.